A part of the historic Civil Rights Act passed in 1964 gave African Americans a right they desperately wanted, a chance to vote.
We were determined to get the right for all people, regardless of the color of their skin.
Selma native and civil rights activist Dr. Frederick D. Reese was a big advocate for African American voting rights. During the 1960s, Reese was the head of the Dallas County Voters League. The civil rights leader was no stranger to opposition. Here, Reese is seen with Dallas County Sheriff Jim Clark with a billy club shoved in his stomach.
And if you think you had it rough in Birmingham with Bull Connor, you never met Sheriff Jim Clark.
Civil rights historian Kenneth Molinux.
Mr. Clark had no qualms about beating up old women, pastors, children who dared to register to vote.
Despite the obstacles, the group's determination to register to vote never faded away. Reese says they needed outside help.
I signed the official invitation, inviting Dr. King to come to Selma to further assist us.
Dr. Martin Luther King and others with the Southern Christian Leadership Conference came to Selma. They helped orchestrate three Selma to Montgomery marches. The first march was inspired by the death of civil rights activist Jimmie Lee Jackson, who was killed by an Alabama state trooper. Dr. Reese vividly remembers the march later known as Bloody Sunday.
Jim Clark and deputies were across the highway, and we were told that we would not be allowed to march across the bridge on the way to Montgomery. We had already decided that we would not be turned unless we were turned.
The leaders on the front line kneeled down to pray.
And when they dropped on their knees to pray, all hell broke loose.
I saw blood flowing. Pandemonium broke out in the crowd in a state of disbelief that this was happening in the United States of America.
2 days later, a second attempt to march was stalled after leaders decided to head back home. It was later known as Turnaround Tuesday. Then, on March 21st, more than 25,000 people.
And this wasn't just for African Americans.
All races and genders from around the world took to the Edmund Pettus Bridge, hiking down Highway 80 to Montgomery, averaging 10 miles a day for 5 days. They arrived at the state's capital.
How long? Not long.
How long?
Because you shall reap what you sow.
The same place Dr. King delivered a speech entitled, How Long? Not Long.
Our God is marching on. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah.
I sat on that platform that day, and I looked out over that sea of humanity. It's a great feeling of great triumph and victory.
Now, in 1965, Congress passed the Voting Rights Act. It was then signed by President Lyndon B. Johnson.